All right, welcome back. And now we are inviting the first corporate for Bazaar. Joining us now is Girish Kousgi, Managing Director and CEO at Can Fin Homes. Good morning, Girish. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. Well, NBFCs and housing finance companies are the flavor of the season. Stocks have been doing well. But first, let me begin with the troubling questions. What is the percentage of borrowers or loan amount that did not pay even a single EMI in the moratorium period, and how many have sought restructuring?
Good morning, Lata. I think Morat is now over and out. It has spread out very well. But just to give the numbers, we had total Morat of 28%, both part one and part two put together. Out of 28, 50% of it, that is 14% of customers, didn't pay even a single EMI for 6 months. Now, having said that, we have seen 2 months of repayments, that is September and October, and we've seen half of November. Now, if you look at the collection percentage in September, it was 93%. In October, it was more than 93%, it was 93.5%. We should not get carried away looking at the collection percentage immediately after a moratorium period, for the simple reason, since customers have not paid for 6 months, and there was maybe loss of partial or full income only for part of the period, maybe 2 or 3 months, customer would be left with excess cash. And therefore, the collection percentage, you know, would obviously increase after the morat period. So if you look at our collection percentage, it is much more in September and October compared to pre-COVID levels. We expect collection percentage to drop by about 2 to 2.5%. If we compare with the pre-COVID levels, it will be still much higher than that. So we are pretty comfortable on the morat. And I think all the 14%, 28% part morat, full morat, delinquent, all that is now out, since we have seen 2 clear months of repayment.
Okay. Mr. Kousgi, good morning. I'm interested to know what's happening with loan growth, because that one has been at an all-time low. Do you expect loan growth to pick up in the second half of the year, and what would the guidance be?
Obviously, immediately after, during the morat and after morat, I think it was more of a strategy for us to manage the book, because if the book goes bad, it will take at least 3 years to get back book to shape. However, as far as business is concerned, once demand is back, it's only a question of a quarter. Now, having said that, we've been doing very well. Quarter one, if you see, we had done little over 400 crores. Quarter two was more than double of Q1. And Q3, we are seeing good traction. So I don't think so. It's only a question of time, maybe another month or two, because if you look at this month, it is far better than last month. So with every passing month, we are seeing, you know, demand picking up. So there might be a shortfall about 10, 15, 20% compared to same month last year. But I think that is easily manageable. So this year we would be a little short compared to last year. No, that's very clearly because demand is not completely back. It is to the level of 80% now. It is far better than what we expected maybe 3 or 4 months back. Maybe another 3 to 4 months back, we expect demand to be close to 100, may not be 100. In Q1, we can see 100. So I think that is not a worry at all.
Q1 of next year, you will see 100, you're saying?
In Q4, we might see 90 to 95%. Okay. I'm just saying, you know, 5% less, because developer market has still not, you know, they've still not come back, because okay, there is some pain, at least in the affordable space, okay. More so in non-affordable. So
it will take, Girish, you know, at least. This is a bit surprising coming from you, because the Bangalore builders told us that demand is very good. Their Q2 numbers have been good. And secondly, we were also expecting that this announcement that even if the price is lower than the circle rate, you don't have to pay income tax on it. These kinds of things will boost loan demand. You don't think so?
No, it will definitely boost demand. I think that is why we have seen, you know, pickup in demand in the last few months, because there have been series of measures taken by RBI and Government of India. That is why we are seeing demand coming back. So now, if you ask me honestly, whether it is an affordable or non-affordable, is the demand back to 100%? The answer is no. Okay. Definitely it is no. And this is one. Number two, very clearly we are focusing on asset quality. Anyway, we are high on liquidity. So nothing to worry on liquidity, nothing to worry on asset quality, because even for last quarter, we showed, I think our NPA was 0.72. Even if I include deemed NPA, it is 0.78. So it's only a question of another 2-3 months time, you know, where demand will be back. So this month probably will hit about 80% of peak levels.
Okay.
So I think another two, yeah.
Okay. So can you tell us, I mean, is it competition from banks that's also impacting demand? And what about your margins? What would a sustainable margin be going ahead?
See, what has happened in what has happened during the Morat period and maybe post-Morat is that since opportunity outside is less, there has been a lot of BT business, right? Since banks have the advantage of lower COF, they are in a better position to either retain the book or grow the book little better than HFCs and NBFCs. Now, this is a fact. Now, having said that, today we have a scheme now, our starting rate is 7%. So if you look at some of the big banks, I think the differential is only 0.05%. Since we have an advantage of COF, our incremental COF is about 6.4, 6.5%. We are able to play that out very well. So it has got nothing to do with demand or the growth or book retention. It's only a question of time. We are seeing certain set of institutions, they are able to probably do business because of more BT-ins, right? So we have a strong retention team. We're able to retain the book. And in another couple of months, you can see we'll be hitting, you know, close to 95%. And probably in after March, we might hit 100%. Maybe we'll try to gain market share post March. Number two, on the margins, I've told this before as well. I think for HFC, if you look at the profile of Canfin, we are almost 100% retail, no corporate exposure, no high ticket lending, and no developer exposure. And therefore, we will be pretty happy if our NIM is upwards of 3. Today it is 4.09 and the spread of up around 2.4%. Today it is 2.8% plus. So the current NIM and spread is not sustainable because we have a very aggressive strategy for onboarding customers by dropping rates and also aggressive strategy to retain the book, to retain existing customers. And therefore, this NIM and spread is not sustainable. However, we will maintain NIM of more than 3% and spread of more than 2.4%.
Okay. Okay, got that. That's some precise guidance that you're giving us. Girish Kosgi, thank you very much indeed for joining us. Have a great 2021 if we don't speak before that. Okay, so that's the word coming in from Canfin Homes. I think it's very a very candid and very clear assessment that we may not get to, you know, FY21 loan growth, there can't be a growth. Mm. We will only get to FY20 levels in the fourth quarter or maybe 90% there. And it's only in Q1 of next year that they expect to increase the amount of loans they give. But market's now opening and it's about a half, 0.8% lower. So 100 points knocked off on the Nifty. It is going to be largely led by the banks because, I mean, the Nifty bank rate we don't have yet. But there could be a series of, you know, Axis Bank, HDFC Bank, SBI are all showing cuts between 1% and 2%. And the one stock in the green, which is leading from the front, is Hero Moto, 1.5% higher. Wipro TCS also, the buyback dates have been announced. And maybe that's also having a positive impact.
Okay, a couple of more stocks, actually, aviation stocks have been looking good. The data, the domestic traffic growth has gone up 30% in the month of October. On a month-on-month basis. SpiceJet, of course, has additional positives going for itself. So that one's up almost about 4-odd%. Keep an eye out on that. Tanla Platforms is one stock that has been defying gravity. So that one's up about 2-odd%. And then you have a couple of these names from the pharma space that have been doing pretty well. So do keep an eye out. Lakshmi Vilas Bank, another day running. That one is down about 20-odd% on expected lines, perhaps. And just keep an eye out on some of these names in the power space also looking pretty good this morning. But I wanted to get Prakash in on this. Prakash, some of these plays, you know, like Tanla Platforms have been doing exceptionally well. You think that whole story has played out or is there more to go for an investor who's perhaps missed the bus here?
Yeah, I know it's a tough call, especially, you know, anecdotally, when you see these kind of stocks run up so quickly and with such quantum, you do tend to start questioning whether it's just fundamentals or scarcity, low float. But, you know, interestingly, Sunya, this was something which was kind of in the offing of, you know, because you had Route Mobile, which came, redefined that space, attracted a lot of attention and a very liberal PE multiple. Tanla was doing the same kind of a business, well more established, well more diversified in terms of its client mix. And of course, the debacle after the Nokia arrangement went off a few years back, they had to get out of it in terms of debt restructuring and all of that. So the salience was there, but whether the salience is worth all this price, that of course we'll have to wait to see, because I think there's a little bit of a scarcity premium that's playing out in some of these platform businesses. So now, of course, the run-up has been too sharp for you to make that kind of alpha beyond this. But I think on dips, you would have to look at this or maybe some other platform businesses, especially related to the telecom space, you know. So I think that's a great space to look at, telecom and technology. That's the intersection that you would have to find some great buys in.
Let's take the 9-10 calls then. Pre-open has settled about 100 points lower on the Nifty, 400 lower on the Bank Nifty. Ashwani, what's your trade?
See, you know, trending market, each time Bank Nifty is down 450, you know, buying out of money calls often is a good strategy. Similarly, on the Nifty, you know, if you open at 12,840, your stops are fairly nearby, basically 12,780, about 12,800. So that way, try to buy the dip. Once, you know, the market turns and starts to make, you know, high of the day. Having said that, I think IndusInd Bank moved very strongly, you know, from some sort of consolidation. So, on a dip, this should be bought with a stop, say around 820, adjust the stop. And maybe in the days to come, you could get levels of 860.
Okay. Sudarshan, what are you going with?
Well, I'll close my long positions and step aside. I'm not buying any dips today. We'll see how the market behaves in the next couple of days. IGL is a buy with a stop at 435 and a target of 491.
Okay. And Mitesh, how about you? I mean, it's going to be a weak start for sure, but will you buy the dip? And what is the 9-10 call?
I think around the index, you know, yes, around 10,850 might attempt a long. Let's see. But on the stock side, I would choose the short stocks because we have had more of long buys and positions in the last few days. So Dabur is a sell with a stop at 510.5 for targets of 486.
Okay. Ashwini, what would you do with Nifty Bank? I mean, that looks like is going to give you a bigger dip. Will you be a buyer in Nifty Bank and bank stocks any?
I would think so. All banking stocks are positive and strong. So, you know, this sort of 500-point dip often gets turned around. So, the first dip, you have to buy. A lot of other people will buy. So, you will probably get an exit at some point during the day. I don't see a total collapse of the Bank Nifty. So, maybe 500 points lower is a good time to buy, say, the 29,500 monthly call or the 30,000 call.
Okay. Some stocks that could stand out today. Hero Motor Corp, of course, on the back of strong retail sales. SpiceJet on the back of the news flow on the 737 Max. And you have a couple of other big gainers like Tanla Platforms that continue to move about 1% higher. But we have more news coming in from the Nestle management. The chairman and managing director says that they are on track to deliver the 11th straight quarter of double-digit growth. Listen in.
I think the core elements of strategy, which is on penetration-led volume growth, that remains. That is the reason why we've had 11 quarters of this growth. Number two is a strong focus on innovation, renovation, and the new platforms of growth. That also remains. And number three is, as we move forward, I think what we've observed in the last couple of years, and it has been exacerbated in the last couple of quarters, is what I call the resurgence of Bharat. Tier 2, Tier 3, Tier 4 towns and rural markets, in fact, are doing extremely well. Urban growth has clearly, for us, improved as compared to quarter 2. See, quarter 2 in urban India for Nestle grew at about 0.7%, and rural India grew at 1.7%. In quarter 3, urban India has grown at about 6%, and rural India has grown at 12%, so almost twice the factor. So urban India has started to come back, but the strength of urban India has been more in the smaller towns. Urban centers are still affected, not because so much because of of consumption or income related issues, but predominantly because of operating issues.
Okay, well, we have to see that interview will play, of course, through the day. We still have a little bit of time. Coal India is showing, okay, yeah, Coal India interim dividend of 7.5 rupees. Coal India is starting 5% lower, and that's largely because there is a huge interim dividend that they are paying out. Prakash is still with us. Prakash, if the dip comes, which it is, the 500-point lower Nifty Bank, are you buying any of the financials?
Oh, yes, absolutely. I think, you know, this is the, you would need to buy in the next hour or so, because the second half could probably see a very different commentary coming through. I think Bajaj Finance, some of these larger banks like Kotak, ICICI definitely would give you that opportunity to get into that short-term tactical trade of sorts. I would certainly be looking forward to this dip and buying into it.
All right. Prakash, thank you very much for being